हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आवर टुडेस चैप्टर इज हैलोअल्केन्स एंड हैलोअरीन्स, वन ऑफ द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट चैप्टर इन ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री. सो वेरी क्विकली लेट अस रिकॉल द बेसिक इन्फॉर्मेशन ऑफ ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री, पर्टिकुलरली अबाउट द अल्काइल ग्रुप. अल्काइल ग्रुप जनरली वी विल रिप्रेजेंट इन द फॉर्म ऑफ R. R is an alkyl group, and you know very well in first PC we learned alkyl group in the sense when you remove one hydrogen from an alkane. For example, methane is the first member of alkane. When you remove one hydrogen, it will converts to an alkyl group called methyl, that is represented by CH3. Similarly, when you remove one hydrogen from ethane, then it converts to CH3CH2 or C2H5, which is called as ethyl group. So basically in 12th or second PUC we will use mostly these two alkyl groups, simplest alkyl group methyl CH3 and ethyl C2H5. Similarly, when you consider aromatic hydrocarbons, in that when you remove one hydrogen from benzene, this is benzene, and when you remove one hydrogen from benzene, it converts to phenyl formula C6H5, and when you add one chlorine to that phenyl group, it converts to phenyl chloride. And when you remove one hydrogen from toluene formula having CH3 to the benzene ring, and from that CH3, when you remove one hydrogen, it will become C6H5CH2, and that is called as benzyl. And to that benzyl group, when you add one chlorine, it converts to benzyl chloride C6H5CH2Cl. Let's begin haloalkanes and haloarenes chapter. Haloalkanes, halo in the sense halogen. Halogens belongs to group 17 in periodic table, and the elements of halogens include fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine and astatine. So when you replace any one hydrogen from alkane and add halogen, then it is considered as haloalkane. Similarly, when you replace any one hydrogen from benzene ring and add halogen, then it is considered as haloarenes. So haloalkanes we can consider as halogen derivatives of alkane. Halogen derivatives of alkane. From alkane, if you remove one or more hydrogen atoms and add or substitute halogen, then the product will be considered as haloalkanes. So here this is methyl chloride, and if you add two halogens, if you substitute two hydrogen atoms with two chlorine, it will become methylene chloride or dichloromethane. Similarly, when you substitute three hydrogen atoms of methane with three chlorine, it will form chloroform or trichloromethane. And haloarenes, as I said, halogen atoms directly attached to the benzene ring. From the benzene ring, any one or two hydrogen atoms, if you substitute with the halogen, then the product will be considered as haloarenes. One example is chlorobenzene. And if you find the two halogen atoms attached to or bonded to the same carbon atoms, then such a halogen will be considered as geminal halide. Example 1,1-dibromoethane. If you find the two halogen atoms bonded to the same carbon atom, then such a alkyl halide is considered as geminal halide. And if you find the two halogen atoms attached to the adjacent carbon atoms, two halogen atoms are to the adjacent carbon atom, then that is vicinal halide, or example 1,2-dibromoethane, that is vicinal halide. Let us see the classification of haloalkanes. Haloalkanes basically classified into two types: aliphatic haloalkanes. Aliphatic means, you know, open chain, and aryl halides, which means halogen attached to the aromatic benzene ring. So aliphatic haloalkanes, based on the number of halogen atoms present in it, it is classified into monohaloalkanes, dihaloalkanes, trihaloalkanes. Example I already mentioned. So again, monohaloalkanes are further classified into primary alkyl halide. If you find only one carbon chain to this halogen or alkyl halide, it is primary. If you find two alkyl groups to the halogen containing carbon atom, it is secondary. If you find three alkyl groups to the carbon atom having halogen, it is considered as tertiary alkyl halide. This is very important. This is a representation of primary alkyl halide having only one alkyl group to the carbon atom having halogen, secondary alkyl halide having two alkyl groups to the carbon atom having halogen, tertiary alkyl halide having three alkyl groups to the carbon atom having halogen. So monohaloalkanes further classified based on the hybridization state of कार्बन टू विच हैलोजन इज अटैच्ड. द वन इज इफ द कार्बन आटम टू विच हैलोजन इज अटैच्ड इज sp3 हाइब्रिडाइज देन इट इज ऑफ थ्री टाइप्स. alkyl halide, in alkyl halide the halogen is directly attached to the sp3 hybridized carbon atom, example methyl chloride. In allylic halide the halogen x is a halogen and it is attached to sp3 hybridized carbon atom, and to this sp3 hybridized carbon atom next is carbon carbon double bond. For example, this is the bond line structure of 3 chloropropene. Here you can find the halogen chlorine is attached to the sp3 hybridized carbon atom, and next to this carbon atom you can find carbon carbon double bond. Similarly, last type of monohalo alkane is benzylic halide. Here the halogen atom is bonded to sp3 hybridized carbon atom, and next to this sp3 hybridized carbon atom there is a benzene ring. Example benzyl chloride is a benzylic halide. And the other type of haloalkanes are vinylic halides, and in vinylic halides the halogen atom is attached directly to the carbon atom, that is sp2 hybridized. Here this carbon atom is sp2 hybridized because you are finding double bond here. And in aryl halide the halogen atom is attached to the sp2 hybridized carbon atom, and that carbon atom is present in an aromatic ring, that is benzene, chlorobenzene. So in both vinylic halide and aryl halide the carbon atom to which halogen is attached is sp2 hybridized. Let us learn about the nature of carbon halogen bond in alkyl halide. As you know, the halogen is more electronegative than carbon. Electronegativity, in first PC we learned the tendency to attract the shared pair of electron. Now there is a bond between carbon and halogen, covalent bond made up of two electrons. Now as halogen is more electronegative than carbon atom, this halogen is going to attract the shared pair of electron towards itself and becomes partially delta negative, and carbon atom becomes partially delta positive. So that makes the carbon halogen bond polar. So remember, the carbon halogen bond in alkyl halide is polar in nature because of electronegativity difference. Now if you come to the strength of carbon halogen bond, as you know, if the size of the halogen is atomic size is very less, then the bond it is going to create is more strengthen. So in halogen the first element is fluorine, then chlorine, then bromine, then iodine. As you go down the group from top to bottom, atomic size is going to increase and the bond strength also is going to decrease. So in that case the bond between carbon and fluorine is stronger and the bond between carbon and iodine is weaker. So as the bond between carbon and iodine is weaker, then it is more reactive. So this is the order of reactivity. Alkyl iodide is more reactive than alkyl bromide, alkyl bromide is more reactive than alkyl chloride, and alkyl chloride is more reactive than alkyl fluoride because of the bond strength. This bond is very weaker, that's why it is more reactive. This bond is very stronger, that's why it is less reactive. Let us go to the method of preparation of alkyl halide. One of the most important method is Groves method. Here we are preparing alkyl halide, RCl, alkyl halide from alcohol in addition to concentrated hydrochloric acid and anhydrous zinc chloride. When you use these two with alcohol, as you can see here, this OH and this hydrogen of HCl release as HCl, and the chlorine of HCl is added to the alkyl group to form alkyl halide or alkyl chloride. Similarly, if you take one example, ethyl alcohol or ethanol, and when you treat with concentrated HCl and anhydrous zinc chloride, there is a release of water H2O, and this chlorine is added to this ethyl group to becomes ethyl chloride. So that is Groves method. Second method to prepare haloalkane from alcohol is Darcy's process. One of the best method to prepare alcohol. One of the best method to prepare alkyl halide. Here, alkyl halide we can prepare by using alcohol and thionyl chloride. SOCl2 is thionyl chloride. When you treat alcohol with thionyl chloride, you can see two gaseous products, sulfur dioxide and HCl. Both are gaseous product. They escape from the product and you will get directly haloalkane or alkyl halide. So as you are getting a pure alkyl halide, because the both byproducts are gaseous in state, they escape very easily. That's why Darcy's process is the best method to prepare haloalkanes.